When I was in school, I had learned that the sun was stationary. It revolved but did not rotate about its own axis. So they used to say, is that mentioned in the Quran? I said, no, that is what I learned in school. And I passed my school in 1982, approximately 12 years back. I had learned the sun was stationary, did not rotate about its own axis. But the Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 33, هو الذي خلق الليل والنهار. It is Allah who has created the night and the day. والشمس والقمر. The sun and the moon. كل في فلك يسبحون. Each one traveling in orbit with its own motion. So the Quran says that besides the sun revolving, it even rotates about its own axis.
Hello everyone. Peace of Christ to all. Let us in here focus together and see how we can expose the lies of Muslims. You know, he said that all they will swim around themselves, like, you know, he's talking about what? He was trying to make you convince you that he's talking about what? He was talking about the moon and the sun, right? Let us read together the verse, and we will show you why Muslims always, they do the same stuff. The Muslims, they think that everybody around is naive, and actually there's a huge number of people that are naive, this is true. They read, but they don't really focus too much. If you read with me, you will see the following. It is He who created the night and the day, and the sun and the moon, all, by the way, this is between two marks, it's not exist in the Quran, but you can read it, no problem. They add them just to make you understand. All swim along, each in its rounded course. By the way, in here, the word rounded, I have no idea from where they get it. I challenge any Muslim to show me where is the word rounded in here. Even, even the word orbit, you see some translation they are using the word orbit, some translation they are using the word course. It says simply, folk, you know, the folk is, or falakin, simply it is, the same as a ship, the same as a boat. That's why it's using the word swim. But I will go with this. Let us assume it says going around, no problem. The verse in here is saying that the night, read with me, it is He who created the night, the day, the sun, the moon, all, okay, or do what? Swim along, each in its round courses. This is not a translation, I will take it as it is, just to play their game. So what does that mean? This is mean that the night, the day, the sun, the moon, all, notice with me, they swim. You see the mistake now? I don't know if you notice what I'm talking about. So what Allah is saying, He is considering the night is a physical thing, and that thing is swimming. The day is something physical, and that thing is swimming too. And the sun is something physical, and it's swimming. And the moon, it is something physical, and it's swimming. It's not me who put the word all there. Here we go. It's in the front of you. All, they swim along. This is not my meat. So what the night do? Swim. What the moon do? Swim. What the sun do? Swim. What the day do? Swim. But all of us, we knew that the night and the day physically, there's nothing moving any place. This is a night and time simply happening because the earth is going around itself. Have nothing to do with the moon or even the sun. Allah, He forgotten here the earth. You notice that? So he's considering that those are four objects. And they are swimming. Object number one is the night. Object number two is the day. Number three is the sun. And number four is the moon. So in here, there's a mistake, not a miracle. Very bad mistake. And the Muslim, they will say to you, this is mentioned in the Quran long time ago, brother, long time ago. Actually, all of us, we knew the Quran, and we showed you the verse before, the video before, in chapter 79, verse number 30, that the earth is a flat. But it doesn't hurt to repeat that again. Let us show it to you. This is chapter 79, verse number 30. And this is why, actually, Muhammad, he is ordering the Muslims to pray in certain time. Like, do Muhammad and you, like as an example, you know, if Muhammad knew about time, and Muhammad knew about what's happening around the earth, and his God he knew, how somebody is going to pray in the morning in Alaska, as an example. The day in Alaska is different from all our days, or the South Pole, or the North Pole. Sometimes the night stay there for 4 months. Here we go, it's a night. So this mean, to pray the morning again, we have to wait 4 months before we pray the morning. Because all of us, we knew, in those areas, this is different from the different areas. Simply, Muhammad, he never knew that there is a day and night at the same time, and he was expecting that all the earth is a flat. This is why, actually, the Muslims, they've been ordered to pray to the Kaaba. You know, the Kaaba simply is what? The Kaaba is a place, exists in the city of Mecca. Okay. Now, if I am exist in America, and I want to pray to the Kaaba, how I can face the Kaaba? I can face the Kaaba if I am really close to the Kaaba. Few miles after the Kaaba, you know, only I can face the Kaaba. After that, the earth is going as around as we knew. So somebody live in America, Abdul, he live in America, he live here. How he can face the Kaaba? What he face, he will be facing this direction. The only way for him to pray to the Kaaba, if he dig a hole or he put his head in the toilet seat, and then he put his head down and his legs is up, you know, let us make his legs like this, and then he will be able to face the Kaaba. So the idea of facing the Kaaba simply proving to us that Islam is a religion believing strongly that the earth is a flat. And that very clear. When the Bible says clearly that the earth is round, or in a close to the shape of round, and even it says that the earth is hanged on nothing, as you will see in the screen, the verse. So there is many evidence proving that. And actually, you know, we can go to many verses and we will show you clearly how the earth is not really round, or how they lie about the circulation of, the day and the night. The day and the night is creatures. Allah created them. They are creatures, as the verse says. Okay, this is Sahih Muslim. This is the hadith from Sahih Muslim. I can make the hadith very small, so to make it fit with the image, but then you will not be able to read it, so I decide to make it bigger. Anyway, this is the hadith number in front of your eyes, and you can go and find it yourself. So forgive me, it might be annoying. I will move the page around to show you. Now, this is the hadith number, book number 001, hadith number 0297. And here, Muhammad, he said, he is the one who is asking the Muslims, do you know where the sun goes? They replied, oh, Allah, Apostle, it's only you who knows, you know. Then the Holy Prophet observed, verily, it, the sun, glides till it reaches its resting place under the throne. Throne of who? Throne of Allah. Then it falls prostrate, and, here we go here, then we go down again. And remain there until it's asked by who? By Allah. Raise up and go to the place whence you came. So the sun is moving from a place to a place. There's a place where the sun set, it's under the throne, and there's a place where the sun rays, to raise have to go to that place whence you came, when you came. And it goes back. You see, it says goes back and continues. And continues. Let us go down. Emerging out from its raising place and then it glid till it's reached its place of rest under the throne and falls. Read the whole hadith. There's not much time left. Sorry. But this is a joke. This is how they lie to you, saying this is a miracle, when it is a big fat joke. It is not real. It is false, because Islam is false. Follow with me with more videos. Thank you very much.